Hi, this is Dennis with Second Chance Tackle. Today we're going to take on a Bass Pro Shop reel. This is the Offshore Angler. It's the GC Gold Cup 50. It's a nice reel for surf fishing or for saltwater fishing. It's the first time I've seen one of these, so I thought you might enjoy seeing how to take this apart, how to service it, and how to put it back together again. As I'm looking at this reel, this top, very, very similar to a Jarvis Walker top. I can't say that Jarvis Walker, which is an Australian company, had these produced for them, for Bass Pro, but that design, that's kind of almost a giveaway on that one. But at any rate, we're going to take this apart. We'll show you how it is made. We'll show you how to service it if you happen to have one of these. And you'll learn a little bit about the bigger saltwater spin fishing reels and how to service them. I start by removing the exterior parts. In this case, I'm going to take this drag adjuster button off and remove the spool. And as I do that, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my channel if you like these kinds of videos. If you do, and you do subscribe, please hit that notification button. That will enable you to see the videos that I am posting and make a determination as to whether that's one you want to watch or not. All right, this reel does not appear to have, well, maybe it does, a side plate that can come off independent of the rotor. No, hard to see, but we'll take the rotor off at this point anyway. There is a spool adjuster, that's the red washer. That adjusts the height of your spool so that you can make sure that you get even line lay. Most of the time, a manufacturer will give you two or three of these washers. And the idea behind it is if your line is spooling low, like this one happens to be spooling high, there should be another washer in here to move the spool up. But there's only one on here. I'll have to see if I can find him another washer. And these came from Kevin, and Kevin sent me a whole bunch of reels of a certain age. And they've all come in dry. In other words, the lubrications have all evaporated. And I'm just a little bit curious as to whether the how long they've been without service. I'm going to take this nut off next. It comes off in a traditional fashion. That's a 15 millimeter nut. And then we have this little guard underneath it. And I put those into a parts tray. I use the bottom of a fast food container as a parts tray. And that helps me to keep track of where these pieces and parts are, so that as I go to reinstall later on, I know where to find them. Before I go much further, I'm going to spray the bail assembly down with a penetrating oil. And just work it to make sure that it loosens and can fire freely. That can set and do its work now. We're going to take that rotor off. This one, interestingly enough, has a double dog system as the anti-reverse. That's the first time I've seen one of those. We have an eccentric that when you're reeling it, it's going to be fine. When you go to back it off, it's going to push these in. These also seem to be very dry as well. All right, let's continue with the work on this. We're going to remove that eccentric spring now. Pulling it up. And off. And it's always good to notice things like where the positioning of those two wings are off to the side. In a straight line, there's a little silver washer and another one that goes on top of that. Then we have some kind of a plastic coupling here. This is a good place to tell you to take pictures, because if you don't take the pictures, you take that piece off and then you wonder where that piece went or how it went, well, it's easily enough to get confused. This one has a stud on the back of the override. This is your override. And it also has a little stud on here, which fits in the groove to that one. So I don't think you have to remove the dogs here, but we do want to make sure that they get loosened up in the process. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to hit it with a light spray of penetrating oil. I generally, the problem with this reel seems to have been that the service has not been done on it. All right. Well, it looks like the case could have come off without that. So let's go down to the case next. We're going to remove the handle. It's a big enough part I can leave outside the tray. And then we'll remove the four case screws. If you have a question on this reel or any reel in particular, if you leave that in the comment section of this reel, I'll try to answer that question for you. And maybe it's a question about, tell me about Jarvis Walker, since I mentioned that the spool kind of has that Jarvis Walker look to it. Or tell me about trade manufacturers and how they make reels for companies like Bass Pro Cabela's. Or maybe you have a reel that you're working on and say, geez, I have a problem, I just can't quite get my hands around it. If you leave that problem, maybe I've seen it, and maybe I can help direct you as to what the cause of that problem is. All right, I'm taking these screws out. What I'm doing is I'm laying them all on my table because I want to make sure that all of those screws are the same. If they weren't the same, I'd like to note the location of the longer or the shorter screws to make sure that I put them back. All right, let's see if the case comes off independent of it. I think it does. There you go. We have a ball bearing inside the case, so I'm going to go ahead and going to oil that bearing. And from what I see, this should come out, the main gear. Main gear's got a lot of dirt on it, so we'll clean that up. And then under the main gear here, we have a screw holding down the oscillation gear. And it looks like we have a piece of metal here. Well, I'm not sure if that needs to come out of the case. We'll just leave that. I'm going to remove the screw that's holding in the axle shaft. Take a picture here. This is important because, well, a lot of things can go wrong in a hurry if you're not paying attention, or if you think you're remembering it, and then you have to lay your project down and go off somewhere. And you don't want to be stuck trying to figure out, okay, where in the world did that go from to? And I want to see if I can get this out. I'm not sure. Yep. All right, so this is the bar. I'm going to lay that right there, just the way it stands in position. This is your crosswind block, same. Because I want to get to that crosswind gear underneath. All of your parts should come out of a reel when you're doing a service. You should inspect them, make sure that there's no chips or cracks, make sure that things like the case and that is clean. And as I mentioned, the reels that Kevin sent me, well, they've been around a while, and I pretty much say with certainty that they haven't been serviced in a while. So make sure you take your time, clean them all up, and them ready to go fishing again, or as my channel is called, give them a second chance. The idea behind this channel is to teach you to do it yourself, but it also serves as an educational vehicle to kind of talk about how reels work. I'll give you a little bit of history in terms of manufacturers and a little bit of a view into some of the different styles of fishing reels as well. We're going to take the two screws that are acting as a collar on the pinion gear and bearing. We're going to take those out. And then we'll be able to remove that, service the pinion gear, and put this thing back together again, making sure that it operates smoothly. I like the style of it. There's nothing that looks extraordinary as a weak point here. This double dog system is the first time I've seen that. That's kind of interesting. And we got a little bit of cleanup to do. There's just a little bit of dried grease in there inside the center collar here. And this is why you take the bearing and the pinion gear out. You got to get in the back reaches of that case to make sure you clean that up. All right, there's a bearing and a shim washer on this. I'm going to take the pinion gear and take a soft brush, say that three times fast. I'm going to make sure that I get the dry greases out of there. And I'm going to wipe it off with a paper towel. I'm using my fingernail, actually, to run in those channels to wipe all that old grease off. Okay. We're going to use some fishing reel grease on that pinion gear. We're going to give it a good coat. Okay, now that we've greased that up, let's reinstall. Get your anti-reverse dogs out of the way. Load that in square. Make sure that it goes into the carrier inside the case. Load that bearing. And then grab the two screws that are acting as the collar on that bearing. Very interesting setup. I haven't seen a double dog setup on a reel before. This is in lieu of a instant anti-reverse, the IAR. So instant anti-reverse has been around 15, 20 years now. So let's put the age of this reel somewhere in the transition stage, probably the 90s. And this, based on the ambassadors that I was working on for Kevin, it would kind of say all of those are sort of in that area. All right, I'm going to go ahead and grab the two. Well, we have that little plastic thing first. That's going to go on the top of the one, if you recall. Got some moving parts on this one. All right, there you go. Goes like that. Then we're going to grab the arms for that eccentric. Got to make sure they're in both. They're right in those little valleys there. Okay, now we can put our two washers on that went on top of that eccentric. If you don't put those washers on, you're going to have a very tight time when you go to tighten down on your rotor. All right, so these are in the columns. We've got the override on now, so it's pulled it in tight. Now we can go ahead and take that rotor and put that rotor back on. Look for your rotor nut that came off in a traditional counterclockwise manner, so it's gonna go back on in a traditional clockwise turning. And do this by hand. Don't rush this. If you don't do it properly, it's going to cross strip. Once you have it started, just tighten it down as much as you can by hand, and go ahead and get that wrench that you used. Tighten it down the rest of the way, and give it a spin. Make sure it's spinning nicely, which it is. Take that anti-reverse off now. Make sure that you have an anti-reverse when you go to stop. So everything's set up properly on that one now. Okay, let's oil that back bearing. And we can take that crosswind gear, clean up the back here. You want to reapply grease on all sides of this. So the back is going to ride against the case. You want to make sure that there's some grease there. The teeth are going to interact with the back of the main gear, and the face is where the crosswind gear, crosswind block is going to slide. So all of them become important on that one. Let's clean up the crosswind block then. This appears to be like an aluminum or a light composite metal of some description. It's the first time I've seen it where they've kind of pinned in the crosswind block. Most of the time, it kind of flows independent. All right, that's that. Clean up this little piece here and pin it back in. I think what we want to do next, I think we want to put that axle shaft in before we do the next piece here, just in case there's some play in that. The axle shaft needs to be clean. Make sure it's smooth. I just use a paper towel to wipe it down. If you do see some corrosion or something on an axle shaft, go ahead and make sure that you buff it off first. All right, axle shaft is in. I'm going to go into my parts tray, find the little screw that holds that in. And this is the only time I think that I've seen where I have a black tray that's been a problem, because, well, these screws are black. So it makes it appear as though they're hiding in there. Okay, that's in place. Tighten that down. Now we want to take this. There's the mistake. There's a little entry point for that tie-down block. So we want to pull off that. Replace the carrier and then put that in and then find your tie down. Interesting. I guess that makes sense, that way that bar doesn't float away on you. Alright, coming kind of down towards the end of this. We want to clean our main gear next. This is just, you can just see it's all just old and dirty grease. And that's kind of the idea behind servicing a fishing reel on a regular basis. Don't let the dirt get in there where it can cause some harm to the reel, and don't let the grease dry out where friction is going to cause the problems. Take that soft brush again, clean those teeth out. While you're doing that, inspect the teeth to make sure they're all uniform and clean. We'll come back now. Make sure that all of this gets a nice healthy coating on front and back. This back set of gears here is going to drive the oscillation gear. Okay, that's all in place now. If we haven't oiled this bearing already, let's oil that. Put our case back on. And we have those four case screws. Now, we noted that the case screws are all the same size. If you like, doesn't hurt to put a drop of oil onto each of these screws. Somebody asked me once, how about Loctite on the screws? I don't recommend that. If you put Loctite on, well, you may have trouble the next time you need to get inside the case of a reel. Yeah, they won't go missing for, you know, vibration from a boat or that, but you may just have a difficult time getting those out. There is a cold Loctite that you do not need heat to remove. If you do go that route, make sure you don't use the one that requires the heat to set it free. All right, that's two. Come up top here. So a very interesting reel, something I haven't seen before with that double dog. And well made. I think that, you know, Bass Pro has probably sold a lot of these, and I think that for the most part, I don't think they've had an issue with them. And it's the first time I've seen a gold cup from Bass Pro. Now, I saw three of the bearings. It says four ball bearings, so I'm going to guess that the other ball bearing is a line roller. Just on a guess. It's either there or in the handle. But they have the minimum amount of bearings in the right places, and that's a plus as far as I'm concerned. Sometimes I'm asked what the right number of bearings is. Should I buy a 12-ball bearing reel or a 2-ball bearing reel? And the question is always answered with, it depends where those bearings are. But the best that you can do is one on each side of the main gear, one on the pinion gear. We saw all of those there. All right, a little bit of oil onto that collapsible handle as well as onto the stud. I go ahead and put this back on now. Give it a twirl. That's a nice smooth operating reel now. I'm going to oil up here where the line guide is. That may be where that other bearing is hiding. Let's make sure that after we've lubed that bale that it's flipping nicely. It is. So the only thing left now to do is to work on this spool to make sure that the drags are okay. So this spool has got a slot in it that holds a retaining clip. And this one's a pentagon. Sometimes you're going to find them that they're squares. Sometimes you're going to find them that they're circles. Doesn't matter. If you have a drag system on the top end of a reel, most of the time you're going to find there is a retaining clip in there. and you do need to remove that in order to remove your drag stack. Okay, we've got Teflon washers. That makes a whole lot of sense for a reel like this. That's because when a trade reel comes in, they generally don't expect their customers buying this type of a reel to have it serviced much. And so they're going to give you drag washers like this. They're perfectly acceptable, but they don't require maintenance. And the reason they don't require the maintenance is that they're a petrochemical product and pretty much self-lubricate. This is an interesting thing. It's a reverse. We have two eared washers and one keyed washer. Most of the time you see two keyed washers and one eared. In this case, the keyed washer, the one with the rectangular center, is going to go in the middle of the stack. The ones with the circular centers are going to go high and low on this. And we're going to grab the, just from a practical standpoint, if I had any questions, if it was a critical part of the reel, I would go back to my pictures. I'm taking pictures here on the video, and I would confirm which way they were seated. Make sure that this goes into the little ridge slot. It is. I just heard that clip in. Now we can take the spool. There's a little bit of dirt underneath the spool. Let's wipe that clean. And put the one washer in. Put the spacer on. Now, if you didn't have a spacer and you had a situation like this where it's kind of gathering up top, go use a plastic bottle of some description, maybe a soda bottle or a milk bottle or something. Just make one. Just cut it out yourself. Fortunately, I have quite a few of these little washers laying around. When a reel goes bad, well, I can always go back and just grab another washer from there, and most of the time that's going to suffice. But again, if you don't have one, make one. Just go trace the one that you do have. There you go, that's a good fit. Trace the one that you do have. See if that's going to have an effect there. Okay, we're working. So that will raise the spool up. As it raises the spool up, this will travel higher and line will wrap more towards the middle and the bottom, which is what was missing on that. Before I do that, I'm looking at my parts tray here. I need to put the tie down on. So I see that this line is coming loose as I'm working on this. I don't like working on reels with line, but I do. But as a general practice, you should remove the line when you're servicing the reel. Replace the line. Monofilm is relatively inexpensive. It does deteriorate and degrade. And I don't know when the last time that the line on this reel was replaced. So I'm not going, maybe it was just replaced before it was sent here. I don't know. So I'm not going to take it off. But what I would recommend to all is that as you service your reel, replace your monofilament. That way you won't have a horror story to tell about the one that got away. All right, tighten it down. We've raised the level of that spool up. Tighten this down now. And it's a good time to give it a test drive. See how we're doing. Well, that's a nice reel. We've raised the spool so that when he casts out in the future, this should reset itself. Hopefully what he'll do is he'll just remove the line and reset it. So that's it. That's your offshore angler. It was sold at Bass Pro Shop. This one is a gold cup. It's a nice reel. It's a 50 size for surf and for saltwater and deep lakes, pier, boat, or from the shoreline. It'll work in all of those situations. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you're a first responder or essential personnel, thank you for everything it is that you do to keep us safe during the pandemic. To everybody, please stay safe, stay well, and stay watching. This is Dennis with Second Chance Tackle. Have a great day.